Who does an elephant see if he has a cracked tooth? Well, the answer is a bit more complicated than just seeing a dentist. Bullwoggy, a beloved elephant of the Birmingham Zoo, has a large crack in his tusk. Looking for a solution to help this big guy, the zoo approached UAB engineer Brian Pillay.
Bullwoggy's a 35-year-old male African elephant who's been at our zoo since 2010. He has a crack in his tusk that goes along the length of it, a longitudinal crack. It's now at a point where it's something that causes him some trouble in the sense that it's allowed some infection into his tusk and it continues to grow. So what we were trying to do with UAB was to stabilize it.
Veterinarians typically treat these types of cracks by adhering large metal rings to the tusk, but Dr. Pillay had a new idea.
And I said, you know, are you guys open to looking at some new materials and better solutions? And they were open to it, and I proposed having a composite material solution. And it took, you know, a few months for the preparation and everything else, and they were open to it, and we went ahead and we were able to come up with something that's a little bit different.
Using their expertise in material science, Dr. Pillay's team of students and researchers came up with a composite fiberglass, a carbon fiber band, and a resin for Bullwoggy's tusk, some of the same materials used in major industries.
The materials that we used essentially are what the new Boeing 787, 70% of the structural body is structural components are made of composites. And it's aerospace, it's the latest in technology in terms of materials. It's lightweight, it's significantly lighter and stronger than steel. So the automotive industry wants to use it extensively to save on weight and efficiency, high performance.
UAB partnered with the zoo to make these high-tech materials work for Bullwoggy.
We put a number of layers of carbon fiber and glass, fiberglass, up on his tusk, and then used a vacuum pump to suck resin, kind of like an epoxy, up into that product, and it set up and became a really hard structure that's going to resist the forces that originally resulted in the crack.
Because this is the first time this combination of materials has been used in such a way, the team from UAB and the zoo must wait and see how well the product works on Bullwoggy.
It should wear very well, but we'll have to continuously monitor it. And if he's going to try to get it off his tusk, he may actually find a way. We hope he doesn't, but he may find a way to do that. So we'll be continually monitoring that, but the vets are also going to be looking at the crack growth, and hopefully we've been able to arrest that crack from growing.
Ultimately, the team viewed the procedure as a success.
Very rarely when you do something for the first time does it actually work like you imagined it will, and it really did. We're hopeful that, you know, when they first observe cracks, when they're still small, we'd be able to go in and do these procedures on them to where it'll prevent the cracks from growing any further, and it'll save the tusks of the elephant.